Oh, hi, Lori. I'm just going to give it a second. Tell me if you can hear my music, because I think I got a good setup right now. You thought you were late. No, I was trying to get a good setup. Tell me if you can hear my music, because it's right here and I have my Bose speaker, so let me know. And then I'll give you guys like another minute or so, and then we'll just get right to it, because I have a lot planned for today. Oh, good! Finally, this is the 11th week that I've been doing this, and I still couldn't get my music right, but today I did. Okay, so I'm wearing a scrunchie, if you like it. Okay, perfect. Okay, so I've moved into the garage, so that way in my house I kind of talk quiet because all the kids are sleeping, but in the garage I can kind of be loud, and let's just hope nobody comes in. That's the neighborhood kid. Okay, so we're going to start with a short core block. You guys are familiar with this. This is our add a trick, and we're going back to planks, but this time we're going to add some side planks. We're going to work the we're going to work the sides of our core today, and then we're going to have a glute series. So a little glute series. You need light to medium dumbbells if you have them. So short core, glute, and then total body is coming up next. Hey, Joss, there are no jump lunges for you, Jocelyn. You know, after I do these workouts, people are like, okay, I don't want this, and I don't want that. It's really just my sister and my best friend. Okay, so anyhow, core, full body, and then a shoulder arm burner. It's so good. I did it yesterday, and that will be 6 minutes. So core, glute burner, total body, shoulder, and arms. Ready? There are burpees, yes, but that's not till later. Okay, so come down. We're going to that add a trick. You're gonna start in a plank position, and you will have 4 1-minute planks, and I'm gonna show you how to make these planks harder for you. Okay, so start on the ground. I just wanna see if you can see me, right? Okay. So I'm gonna start the timer. We're gonna just move, okay? So you are not stopping until I tell you to stop, unless you need a break. 3, 2, 1, come into a plank position. This is 1 minute, okay? Back is flat. You can spread your feet. Your option is to be on your knees, but your butt is not in the air. We are flat planks. So this first plank, we are just gonna hang here. I want you to draw your belly in. Think about pushing the floor down. You're looking down, you're not looking at me. That was 30 seconds, you have 30 more. Push your palms in, squeeze your knees, right up to your glutes. I'm wearing a scrunchie because I washed my hair today. I don't want you to crease. 15 more seconds, come on.
Option to
your hand that can help you lift your hips a little higher. Remember your option, lower impact, you drop to that knee. It's only been 10 seconds. All right, push your forearm into the ground or the mat, whatever you're using. You're gonna switch to the opposite side and hold for 30. You've got 7 seconds. 3, 2, switch. Forearm down, scissor your feet, lift your hips up. So feel the abdominals working, kind of hold together to hold this side plank. 20 seconds, you're going back to that 1 minute plank. Look up at that arm, that's gonna kind of help you get those hips up higher. Last 10. We've got 3, 2, 1. 1 minute plank. You have 2 more 1 minute planks. All right, so now you're here again. So if you want, spread your feet out a little bit wider. Start to tap your shoulders without twisting your body, without rotating it. And if you cannot do that, pop down to your knees. Literally just do a couple, see how it feels. Pop back up to the plank. We have 30 more seconds. And we go into that side plank. Hold on to it. All right, so you should be pulling your belly button in nice and tight. If you were to touch your belly, it should feel hard, right? Hold for 10, squeeze your knees up, right into your quads, come on. 3, 2, side plank. I am timing you, see? All right, push. Push that forearm right into the mat here. Push it in firm, lift your hips. And if you want a challenge, go ahead and pulse your hips up. Only if you want it, you can even do that on your knees. Okay? You've got 10 seconds. And then you're gonna switch to the other side for 30. 3, 2, switch. So from here, we're here for 30. And then we're gonna have a scissor crunch, okay? I'll show you what that looks like. You keep holding this plank position though, okay? So your next move comes in 10 seconds. Watch me. Crunch, scissor. Okay? 3, 2, 1. Come into this position. Palms up, or you can tap your toes down. You can hold behind your knees, or you can come out straight. So keep breathing here. You don't necessarily have to have straight legs if you want, but if you need that option, you're gonna hold your knees and tap. Okay? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Last plank. Here we go. Last plank. Hold. 1 minute. So in order to make this minute go by fast, you can do something different. Tap your knees down. All right, you can do those shoulder taps. Or you can chill here. But you're not resting unless you absolutely, absolutely have to rest. Hold it for 30 more. If you're struggling, I want you to just try to hold your plank. Don't worry about fancy stuff. Keep going. Can you hold it for 15 seconds? Yes, you can. Straighten out, pull the lats down, and push the floor down. Breathe. Last 3, 2, 1. Come into your side plank. This is our last round. Side plank in 3, 2, 1. So remember, arm can be up for a little bit out of balance, or you can drop that bottom knee down and focus on lifting the top part of your hip, okay? I want that hip to be nice and high, as if you had to push something into the ceiling like a nail, and your hip has to hold it up. 10 seconds here. 3, 2, switch. Here we go. Lift.
momentum. So look up at those fingertips. Look up and lift your hips up. Try to make sure your lower bottom part of the hip is not near the mat. You want it high. Even if that means you're on your knee to get that hip high, that's how we work the obliques. You've got 10 seconds, then we go into that scissor crunch. It's probably the hardest move in this series here, in my opinion. 3, 2, 1, here we go. So you want to be sitting on almost your tailbone. Sit back and just scissor those feet. Slow or fast, doesn't matter. 15 seconds down, remember your option. Hold behind your knees and tap, but make sure you're leaning back with a straight spine here. 10 seconds. Oh, here we go. Your next move is a single leg V up. We go in 3, 2, 1. This is it. Last move in your core block. So try to straighten your leg up. Your option is to limit your range of motion. Claps your hands right underneath here. That's your option. This is your challenging option. Extend your leg up. My legs are sore. Okay, guys, 7 seconds. Hold on to it. 3, 2, 1. Okay. Grab some water. We're gonna zoom right into a glute burner, so you need dumbbells for this next set. Everybody good? Okay, a set of dumbbells. We work for 45 seconds and we have 3 exercises. We're in a hip bridge the whole time, so when you're in a hip bridge, your butt has to be squeezed nice and tight, and that will protect your back, but tell your muscles to start working. Grab your lighter set of dumbbells, okay? So, we have a glute bridge with a chest fly. That's your first exercise for 45 seconds. We go in 15, get set up. All right, come into your hip bridge. 3, 2, 1, 45 seconds. Fly and close. So for reference, I'm using 10-pound dumbbells here. My only other option that I have would be a 5 or a 15, and I want a good range of motion, so I'm sticking with the 10s. You want a bent elbow, squeeze your butt, your hips are up. Try to hold your hip bridge the whole time. As you close your arms, squeeze your armpits together. Any higher? Can you get those hips up any higher? Have they fallen down throughout this movement? What do we got? 5 seconds. You're going into a skull crusher. You keep going. Watch me. Okay? We are continuously moving. Skull crusher. 3, 2, 1. Hips up. Come on. Those dumbbells are bending. Your elbows are forward like 2 headlights. Those dumbbells come past your forehead. Go ahead and check your hips. Are they dropped? Lift them up high. Push your upper back into the mat here. What do we got? You've got 15 more seconds. And then you'll get a glute break before we do this again. Last 3, 2, dumbbells on your hips. Let's pulse. Halfway lift. This should not feel good. Come on. Last 15 seconds. If you're struggling, drop your dumbbells and just use your hips. So you're coming halfway down, right back up. Or you can use one dumbbell, or you can hold it here. Where are we? You've got 20 seconds. Come on. Push through your heels to get your hips up a little higher. Push and lift. Last 5. You've got 4, 3, 2, 1. Sit up, stretch. Okay, so your glutes should be on fire right now, right? Give yourself a second. Grab some water, and we're gonna do that one more time. And go into our full body.
Okay, so we've only been working for 12 minutes total. So we do that circuit one more time. You're gonna feel it in your glutes again. Okay, we go in five. Hip bridge, chest fly. 3, 2, 1. So you're bending your elbows. They should be slightly bent and you're opening and closing like you're giving someone a super big hug. Not during COVID, obviously. Just kidding. I'll hug all the people. And I'm not even a hugger. That's how much I miss people. Okay, bend those elbows. Come on. Open and squeeze. So if you're not squeezing on the way in, what are we doing? Not even working. So big squeeze. 10 seconds. You're going into that skull crusher. 3, 2, 1, skull crusher, hips up. So try to pull your dumbbells past your forehead, okay? And squeeze your triceps at the top. So think about focusing on the back part of your arm. Put your mind back there. Elbows should bend. They should be bending at a 90 degree. So if you were to look up right now, you would see a number 11 with your arms. So they're not out wide. They're close together, narrow. Timer. Okay, you've got 10 seconds. Come on. We're going into that hip toss finish. 3, 2, drop those dumbbells here. Pulse and lift. So scooch your heels closer to your butt to get you some more range to lift to the ceiling. Half leg, lift. So your abdominals should still be engaged this whole time. Really squeeze your ribs down to your hips. Lift, lower. All right, guys, you have 20 seconds. Finish it out. I told you this was a glute burner. Come on. Oh, we got 10. Come on, finish strong. Finish strong here. Stay up. 3, 2, 1. Nice job. That was hard. All right. So, the way our next circuit is going to work is we have full body movement. Everybody good? Okay. All right. Here we go. So, work. This is total body, so there is some cardio. You'll need a light set of weights and medium set. We have 45 seconds of work, 3 circuits. They'll range from 45 seconds, 30 seconds, and 15 seconds, okay? We are finishing with a shoulder burner. Here's what we're starting with. Alternating curtsy lunge with an overhead press. I will show you the 3 exercises before we go. So your dumbbells, I'm using my lighter set here. Curtsy lunge and press. And you're switching sides, okay? If you need an option, do this without dumbbells. Your second move is a plank jack. I know we already did a lot of planks, but so here we go. This is a plank jack, okay? Your 15 seconds, dumbbell squat press. I'm gonna use heavier dumbbells for this last move, but for time's sake, I'm just gonna show you this, okay? 15 seconds and then we rest. We'll do the circuit twice, and you have 3 circuits. So get both your sets of dumbbells here. Just watch your area for those curtsy lunges. All right, here we go. 45 seconds, curtsy lunge. In 3, 2, 1. Step behind you, come back to center. So keep your body nice and straight, so you don't want to be doing your lunges this way. You want to keep your body straight. And press. All right, 20 seconds down already. You are gonna go into your plank jacks. When I tell you. So we're pressing overhead, making sure that we do not feel any pain in the low back. Good, take deep breaths. Exhale as you press. 5 seconds, plank jacks for 30, come in. 3, 2, 1, on your mat. So your option,
come to your knees and you extend your toe out as your option. 15 seconds, come on. You can also stay in a plank and walk your feet out. Okay, five, come on. Grabbing your heavier set of dumbbells in 3, 2, 1. Squat press, 15 seconds. Rest is right after this, come on. Three, two, one, rest. How we feel about that one? So your heart rate should be up, right? Yeah. Okay, here we go. Alternating curtsy lunge with an overhead press. We go in three, and two, and one. Okay, you keep going at the top of my shoe. Alright, there we go. So lunge, reset. When you lunge, try not to let your dumbbells fall. Keep them right at shoulder height. Okay, kind of some isometric holding there. The curtsy lunge also helps to work the inner thighs. Okay, hello. About 15 seconds here. Step all the way back and behind you. So a long stride behind you, bending that knee. Plank jacks in 3, 2, 1. 30 seconds. So we have a long straight spine, butt is not in the air, butt is flat. Body is straight. 15 seconds. Last five, four, three, two, stand up. Squat press with dumbbell. 3, 2, 15 seconds. So use the thruster to drive up. So use your hips to push these overhead. These are heavier dumbbells, hopefully. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. First circuit done. Okay, grab some water, towel up a little bit. I have a neighbor over here looking at me. What's she doing? Okay, same idea. Circuit number 2 of 3. Dumbbell snatch. You can bring your medium or heavy dumbbell, it doesn't matter. We're going to be moving off the spot, so watch. Dumbbell snatch, come back. Snatch, jump back, or snatch, walk back. I'm going to use my heavier one. 30 seconds of mountain climbers, and then 15 seconds tricep pulse. Okay, that's what we got. That's going to be a burner, that last one. Okay? All right. So we're going to go on 20 seconds. I get my timer set up. Dumbbell snatch, 45 seconds. We're going to have a little bit of agility here. So make sure you don't fall. Make sure your area is clean. Chest is lifted. We go in 3, 2, 1. I like to jump back, but honestly, you can just walk back. It's up to you. I also might tuck my shirt in a little bit. There we go. Okay, so you're swinging. Let me break this down. You come forward in a little squat, dumbbell overhead. That's how you'll end up, and then you bring your body back to base. 15 seconds. It's almost like a little hop. With a wide squat finish. All right, we've got 5 seconds. Give me 2 more. Come on, last one. Mountain climbers, let's go. 30 seconds. So when we hit a mountain climber, shin. shins are close to the mat, butt is not up, shoulder over wrist. 15 seconds. Hold on, last five. 3, 2, 1. Tricep kickback pulse, 30 seconds, go. Palms up, let's go. So you're tipping from the hip. Take a deep breath, the rest is coming after this. You've got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rest. How we doing? That snatch is good, really gets you. Listen, I wanna show you that tricep kickback while you're resting from up close. Hinge from the hip, shoulders back, lift your dumbbells up and pulse. So my hands are still close to my body, okay? You're just pulsing. By the way, do you see all these bikes? Remember last week I was like, can you guys get your stuff out of my garage? It's my workout space. I have about 30 more bikes in there. Anybody need a bike? Just kidding. Okay, here we go. Grab your heavier dumbbell, last set on this round. In 3, 2, 1. Dumbbell snatch, let's go. So you don't have to do this very fast. You can go as slow as you need to, but when you snatch, tummy is braced so that you don't put pain in that low back or any kind of negative pressure. 20 seconds down, almost halfway. Get that dumbbell overhead. Squat forward. Remember, you squat and walk back if you need to. How are you doing? The last comment I see is thank God for no jump lunges. Can't see that far away. Oh, 3, 2, 1, mountain climbers. Let's go, 30 seconds. Get the deck. So think about driving your knee in between your hands. Drive it forward, shift body weight, 15 seconds. Come on, faster. You've got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 15 second pulse, tricep, go. Arms up, come on. Come on, elbows up, lift. Palms face up. You've got 3, 2, 1. Woo! How we doing? Everybody good? No joke. All right. Last lap. Last circuit. Before our shoulder finisher. It's my least favorite round, I'll be honest. Here go your burpees coming up, okay? So we're starting with a renegade row. You guys should know by now I love planks. So a renegade row is this. Basic. You can do this on your knees and row, okay? And then we've got two cardio rounds. Speed skaters, which are these. Okay? And then a burpee. Two times, that's it, okay? So let's start in 15 seconds on the ground. I'll show you how to modify as we go. Grab your heavier dumbbells. You can do it. Set yourself up. We go in 3, 2, 1. Spread the feet out wide, pull. So when we do a renegade row, we need a wide base at the bottom, so feet are wider than normal. And as you pull those dumbbells and squeeze between your shoulder blades, option again, you're here. What you do not want is to rotate your hips open. You want to keep them square to the ground. You've got 20 seconds. Elbow close to your body. Come on, last 10. You got it. 3, 2, 1. To your feet. Speed skater, 30. Go. If you want something a little more challenging, touch the ground. Can you do it? Only 30 seconds. You can. Your option. Hey! Okay, where was I? I kind of lost track. Okay. Burpees in 3, 2, 15 seconds. Let's go. Now I want everyone to jump. Because you know what? You only have 15 seconds. Yes, Lori, jump. Jump. 2, 1. Rest. Grab some water. Can everybody jump on that burpee? Comment. Did you jump? Watching. All right, guys, last round. Even if you can only get one or two jumps after that burpee, that's better than none, right? Better than none. And then you'd be like, yeah, I jumped. Good for me. Okay? I jumped. Good job. Okay, hopefully you had enough recovery time. Let's get into that renegade row. 3, 2, 1, go. 45 seconds, your last circuit for full body. And then we hammer in on the shoulders and the arms. Spread those feet out wide. Remember your option. This is fine. This is not fine. You can be on your knees and still hit that row. You've got 15 seconds. Squeeze that tummy, come on.
Good? All right, I'm gonna set my timer up here.
We have two rounds. We'll break after that first round, okay? I'll give you a break. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, alternating tricep extension. So you're alternating, but you're keeping that dumbbell and those elbows up. And you're squeezing the back of the arm, so I need you to really focus on squeezing. You're halfway, 15 more seconds. So extend that dumbbell out all the way, big squeeze out. So if you're swinging it like this, you need something heavier, or you need to focus on isolating and lowering and slowing your movement down. Stand up, lateral, front raise at the same time. Here we go, front, lateral. So those dumbbells do not come any higher than our shoulders, okay? So if you're able to do one of these the whole time, likely you need something a little heavier, okay? Stay with it. Alternating each side, arms are straight. You have 7 seconds, we go into that reciprocal bicep curl. 3, 2, 1, palms under, curl up, rotate, set it down. So your elbow stays right under your shoulder the whole time as you come through this. So our elbows don't come out. Okay, you want them right under the shoulder. Not about going fast. You want to make sure you have nice, strong movements here. We're going to hit our reciprocal rows in 5 seconds. 3, 2, tip from the hip, reciprocal row. So now try to speed it up. Like you're punching someone on the ground, okay? Get a little aggressive. 15 seconds, come on. We finish with that overhead press. We're gonna do this 3 times because I think we can handle it. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Overhead press, 30. Let's go. Now you can split your stance, stagger your feet, but I don't want your elbows coming down. I want them to stay at shoulder height, and you press them in front of you, okay? Pull your lats down, so right under your armpits, pull them down and away. 15 seconds. Pull up, reset. Last 3, 2, 1, rest. So we're gonna do that 2 more times. Because it only took 2 minutes and 30 seconds. I think we can do it. All right. So let's get going in 15 seconds. We go back to that alternating tricep extension. If you have trouble washing your hair tomorrow, you did it right. Unless you don't wash your hair every day. 3, 2, 1. Tip, elbows up, go. So, I've only looked at you to make sure that I'm in the camera, but I want you to look down, keeping that neck right in line with your spine. So squeeze the back of the arm. Every time you're extending, you're squeezing. Maybe the side pony is coming back, because all that tie-dye stuff came back, which makes me feel old. We used to tie-dye out front of our house, right, Lori? We would tie-dye all our clothes. 3, 2, 1, front and lateral raises. I'm pretty sure at one point my sister had a tie-dye party in high school, right? Is she commenting? No, not yet. Okay, so pull your shoulders down. You don't want to hunch them up. You want to relax them away from your ears. Pull them down and just do this movement slowly. You don't have to do it fast because your arms are probably getting tired right now. Focus on it. You've got 3, 2 biceps, here we go. Curl up, reset, right back down. So your palms come up, rotate them, face them out, and do a nice slow curl on the way down. What have we got? 10 seconds, okay? Then we're gonna go into that reciprocal row. 3, 2, 1, tip. Row. So as you pull your dumbbells up, squeeze your shoulder blades together. Come on, 15 seconds. Yes, you can. Elbows. that chest square to the ground. Overhead press. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Press, reset. Almost there. Stay in it. Push, reset. Now try not to cheat. Try not to pull them down. Keep your elbows in line with that shoulder height. 15 seconds. Pushing them right in front of your face. Good. Recover. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Recover. One more round. Okay? Last round. Alternating tricep extensions to start. Here we go. 3, 2, and 1. Elbows up, alternate. So try to slow it down a little bit. So hold it up for 1 or 2 more counts extra. 1, 2, 3, bring it in. Good. Those elbows should be really close to your ribcage. You should really feel them tighten. 10 more seconds and we hit that lateral front and side raise, or that lateral and front raise. Push your butt back. Keep it hips back. 3, 2, 1. Okay, so reach that dumbbell in front of you. Reach just a little bit more. This is your last round, okay? So really try to stay in it to the finish line. Not all about speed here. This is about nice, strong strength that we're building in the upper body here. Check out my Suns Out, Guns Out workout on YouTube. It's really good. 15 minutes, if that. I did that while my kids were standing right next to me. They actually come in the video. Okay, keep going. My timer went off. My screen went blank. Okay, 180 curls. Go. Bicep curl. Curl up. Nice, back down. Up. Perfect. So palms out. Palms up. Palms out. So rotate your wrists at the top. Pull it down.
Thanks so much for coming during our nap time workout, and I hope you guys have a great rest of your weekend.